For over 25 years, students from across the Granite State have come together to match wits with their peers. The competition can be fierce, but so can the fun. Even so, the stakes are high because only one team can win. The Granite State Challenge! Now, here's your host, Jim Janot.
And hi there, everybody. We welcome you again to another game of Granite State Challenge. Very late in our opening round of competition, as you know. We have 16 opening round games. We have 14 of those completed, with winners advancing to the second round. Two new schools to compete tonight, the winner also to move on into our second round of competition. So let us introduce you to the teams playing in tonight's opening round game. First of all, we have the team from Keene High School. It enrolls approximately 1,700 students. Keene is located in New Hampshire's Cheshire County.
Hi, I'm Leo and I'm a sophomore.
Hi, I'm Ashley and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Shelby and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Miles and I'm a sophomore.
With us for the program are the coaches for the team, Andrea Walker-Brown and Mark Hayward. They are the Blackbirds from Keene High School. All right, that's team number one participating. Let's find out who they'll be playing against. And they will be playing against the team from Merrimack High School. Enrolling about 1,650 students, Merrimack located in New Hampshire's Hillsborough County.
Hi, I'm Patrick and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Andrew and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Molly and I'm a sophomore.
Hi, I'm Roshni and I'm a sophomore.
Also with us for the program, the coach for the team, Susan Ruggieri, and her alternate is Tyler Galimo, and they are the Tomahawks from Merrimack High School. And our last introduction is to let you know who our judges are this season, and once again, we welcome back Mary Riley Potter and Ann Belanger. All right, those are the introductions. Now we're ready to play. Hope you are at home as well, as we have 10-point toss-ups in this, the first round. We'll get on into the bonus and 60-second round, but Keene and Merrimack, 10-pointers. Good luck. Here we go. This theory states that the universe began 1,018 billion years, and that is Keene Miles.
Big Bang.
The Big Bang theory is correct. What United States state has the longest coastline? Shelby of Keene.
Florida.
Merrimack, Roshni.
Maine.
It is Alaska. Weir's Beach is located on what New Hampshire lake? Miles of Keene. Merrimack. Weir's Beach is located on Lake Winnipesaukee. Which metal used in jewelry is called white gold? Leo of Keene.
Silver.
Merrimack.
Platinum.
Somebody press. All right, that's Anjou.
Platinum
is correct because it looks like white gold. How old do you have to be to become president of the United States? Miles of Keene.
35 years old.
35 is correct for your 10 points. Now for 10 points, which term is used to designate the last movement or passage of a musical composition such as Patrick of Merrimack?
Finale.
A finale, such as a sonata or a symphony. Finale is correct. Identify the two-word term designating the division or splitting of a cell into two approximately equal parts. Patrick of Merrimack.
Mitosis.
Keene, Miles.
Meiosis.
We're looking for the two-word term of binary fission. For 10 points, the launch of this satellite on October 4th, 1957. Patrick of Merrimack.
Sputnik.
Sputnik 1 is correct. The space race between the U.S. and Soviet Union began. Now what we want you to do is name the English-born woman who on January 23rd, 1849 became the first U.S. woman. Roshni of Merrimack.
Virginia Dare.
I can repeat it for Keene. Name the English-born woman who on January 23, 1849, became the first U.S. woman to receive a medical degree. Her first name is Elizabeth. Shelby.
Elizabeth Sanger.
It is Elizabeth Blackwell. Here's your next 10-pointer. Until Pearl Harbor, the worst naval defeat in the United States history happened on this main river in 1779, when the British destroyed the naval expedition sent by Massachusetts and the Continental Congress. Name the river. Leo of Keene.
Mississippi.
Merrimack. It was the Penobscot River. Very quickly, tell me, how many years are there in 87? Leo of Keene.
87.
87 is correct. This United States president was the first American to receive a Nobel Prize. Patrick of Merrimack.
Theodore Roosevelt.
It was awarded for his work in negotiating the Treaty of Portsmouth and ending the Russo-Japanese War. Well done. Theodore Roosevelt is correct. Which beautiful young man beloved by Aphrodite was killed? Roshni of Merrimack.
Adonis.
Yeah, Adonis is correct. Paper and pencil is found in front of you if you think you might need it for this math question. If Bill's time and a half rate for his overtime hours is $9.30, what is his regular hourly rate? We'll give you a little time. If Bill's time and a half rate for his overtime hours, Anju of Merrimack?
$6.20.
$6.20 is correct. Now for 10 points, what is Venus standing on in Sandro Botticelli's famous painting, Birth of Venus? Patrick of Merrimack?
A clamshell.
Judges, you'll take that. Miles of Keene?
An oyster shell.
You needed a seashell, a scallop shell, or a half shell. Here we go for 10 points. We want you to name the rock band that made its debut in 1998, featuring four animated members, 2D, Murdoch Nichols, Noodle, and Russell Hobbs. That rock band's name was Gorillaz. This Derry, New Hampshire native attended Pinkerton Academy and was the first American in space. Miles of Keene.
Alexander Shepard.
Merrimack. You could have said Al Shepard and got away with it, but it was Alan Shepard, not Alexander. Here we go for 10 points. Which term designates the turning or bending of a ray of light or sound wave as it passes? Anju of Merrimack.
Diffraction.
This is for Keene. Which term designates the turning or bending, Leo?
Refraction.
Refraction is correct for the 10 points. Identify the Virginia-born principal founder of Texas, who is sometimes called the father of Texas. Miles of Keene.
Sam Houston.
Good try, Merrimack. It was Stephen Austin. For 10 points, what is the small pear-shaped pouch attached to the common bile duct? Anju of Merrimack.
Pancreas.
Good try, Keene. Shelby.
The liver.
It is the gallbladder. There's the sound ending our round, and we've had a good, tightly contested opening round of play, with Merrimack getting a little bit of a lead by a score of 60-40, but things very much up in the air right now as we get ready for our bonus round. Before we get there, though, we're going to take a timeout. Lori Warner joins us each week at this portion of the program. She talks prior to each show to the team members of the teams playing that day, and right now she's talking to the team from Keene High School.
Thank you, Jim. We have the students from Keene High School here with us, and I'm talking first to Captain Leo Hastings. Now, as a sophomore, you're your class president.
I am.
You're the captain of this team. Mm-hmm. You're on the student council. So do I take it you're going to have a small country of your own someday?
No. I'm not going to government, but I'll decide later.
All right. Yeah. And I hear that your team has a limerick.
Yeah, we do have a limerick that we collaborated on. And
so, and I think we need to hear it if they bother collaborating. Okay.
There once was two girls and two guys who were trivia buffs in disguise. With fingers like dancers, they had all the right answers, and they went on to claim the first prize.
Nice. That's a prediction, too, as well as a limerick. That's a great one. Our next student is Miles Walker. Now, you're a sophomore also, and you've been playing piano since you were 5 years old.
Yes, I have.
Now, am I right in saying that you practice 3 hours a day?
Yeah.
You realize your most parents dream, right?
They actually don't like listening to me play all the time. They tell me to stop it at night.
I'll trade children. Okay. And you also are involved in some dance as well.
Yeah, I do ballet and tap. I've been doing that since I was 10.
How did you get involved with so many artistic endeavors?
I don't really know. I've always enjoyed it. My mom started me on music when I was little. She always played a lot of music in the house and recordings.
That was same at my house. That's wonderful, though. Are you thinking about continuing on with piano after school?
Yes. Yeah, okay. Yes.
You would have to after practicing that much. Shelby Redfield, you are a junior. And tell us a little bit about your big trip to France this summer.
Last April, I went with the school on an exchange program. I lived with a family for a week and a half, and it was a really great experience because I was the only one who spoke English. No one spoke any English at all, so I had to speak French the whole time, which is a great learning experience. Yeah. And then we went to Paris for a couple of days, and I was so happy to finally get to Paris, I started to cry.
That's amazing. It is. And Ashley Yanis, you are, oh my gosh, you are so busy. Cross-country ski, there's track, there's math, there's French, there's the Envirothon, and the finer things, which, what is that?
Well, it's a group that we, actually, Shelby and I started, and another friend, started because of the office, partly because they had a club on it, and because we like the finer things in life. So we drink tea, we read books, and things of that sort. It's a pretty civilized club,
I would recommend an Ivy League school, and one of those wealthy men is a husband. Okay. Well, it is now time to get back to our game, so we will find out what happens. It's back to you, Jim.
Well done. Thank you, Laurie, and thank you, and welcome to the team members from Keene High School into a very good game early in our contest, trailing by only 20 points, 60 to 40. We head into our second round. This is our bonus round. We'll still be asking the 10-point toss-up questions. Get the toss-up right, and your team has a chance at bonus points. So good luck, Keene and Merrimack. Here we go for 10 points. Name the two Canadian provinces that border New England. Miles of Keene.
Ontario and Quebec.
Merrimack. Quebec and New Brunswick. This 20th century Spanish artist is perhaps best known for his surrealistic work, Miles of Keene.
Salvador Dali.
Salvador Dali is right. Good anticipation. So Keene's on the board. Let's go over to them for some toss-ups, for some bonuses. Leo, you're the team captain. You'll be speaking for them. But right now, let's choose a category. From In 3D, and now a musical number, Hail Caesar. In 3D, and now a musical number, Hail Caesar.
Musical.
Musical number?
Let's go with the musical number. Again, Leo, you can talk to everybody, but I will take your answer as the team's answer for 5 points apiece. Identify each of the following bands or musicians with numbers in their names. This Irish group is led by Bono.
You too.
Correct. This rapper was discovered by Eminem.
Tupac.
50 Cent. Band of Brothers from Gary, Indiana, featuring a young Michael.
Oh, Jackson 5.
Jackson 5.
You got a 10 out of 15 on the bonus. Let's go with a toss-up. Identify the gray snouted beetle that feeds on the seed pods. Molly of Merrimack.
Boll weevil.
Boll weevil is absolutely right. So let's go over to Merrimack for a chance at some bonus. Patrick, you're the team captain. You'll be speaking for them. Let us choose from In 3D, Hail Caesar or Go with the Flow. In 3D, Hail Caesar or Go with the Flow. Patrick?
We'll go with 3D, Jim.
Okay, let's go with 3D. And again, Patrick, I take your answer for the team. Identify each of the following sculptors. Renaissance artists who sculpted Pieta and David.
Pass.
Michelangelo. 20th century artist most known for his mobiles, including Lobster Trap and Fishtail and Red Horse.
Pass.
Alexander Calder, and famous for his works The Thinker and The Kiss. Patrick, that was Rodin. Okay, tough category. Let's go with another 10-point toss-up. Name the tendon that attaches the calf muscle to the heel bone. Miles of Keene.
Achilles tendon.
Achilles tendon is right for the 10 points. Back to Keene we go. Hail Caesar is still there. We've got Go with the Flow, and we have Changes. Hail Caesar, Go with the Flow, Changes.
Changes, please.
Changes it will be. Answer each of the following concerning transformations. What Pinocchio wants to be changed into?
A real boy.
Correct. What Lot's wife was changed into in the Bible?
A pillar of salt.
What?
A pillar of salt.
A pillar of salt.
Correct. What the fussy baby changed into in Alice's Adventures in Wonderland?
A pig.
15 out of 15 on the bonus. Well done. Let's go with a 10-point toss-up. Identify the author of Tortilla Flat, East of Eden, and The Pearl. Ashley of Keene.
John Steinbeck.
You got it for your 10 points. So back to Keene we go for another opportunity at bonus points. Hail Caesar, go with the flow, or blowing in the wind. Hail Caesar, go with the flow, blowing in the wind.
Blowing in the wind, please.
Let's go with blowing in the wind. Answer each of the following associated with the word wind. Play and later movie based on the famous Scopes monkey trial.
Oh, no. Inherit the wind.
What?
Inherit the wind.
Inherit the wind.
Correct. Song about Marilyn Monroe, sung by Elton John, and then later adapted for Princess Diana.
Candle in the Wind.
Correct. Children's book by Kenneth Graham, featuring Mr. Toad, Mr. Badger, and Mole.
Wind in the Willows.
Correct. 15 out of 15 on the bonus. And there's the sound ending our round. We're halfway through, and Keene has taken advantage of the second round to take the lead at the halfway mark, 110 to 70 in a very well-played game thus far. 60-second round just around the corner. Before we get there, let's ask Lori to rejoin us, this time talking with the team members from Merrimack High.
Thank you, Jim. We've got the students from Merrimack High School here, and we'll start with our captain, Patrick Green. Now, you're a senior, Patrick.
Yes.
You are. And after school, what are you planning on doing?
I'm planning to go to WPI to get a degree in robotics engineering. That or RPI. Still not entirely sure which one I'll go to.
Well,
but
you've got plenty of time.
Yeah.
Not until the end of the school year, anyway. And your interest in robotics, what brought that about?
Actually taking a class last year in robotics. I've always kind of liked building things, but I found that I had a particular affinity for robotics and the mechanics therein.
Yeah, that's kind of a sensible brain. I don't have that one, but I'm glad you do. Our next student is Anju. And Anju, at 16, you are a senior.
Yep, I skipped the fourth grade at Fairgrounds Elementary School in Nashua.
And you also took an exotic trip over to India.
Yeah, last summer, just me and my sister went to India, and we lived with my grandmother for 6 weeks. And we saw lots of monkeys there. It's one of my favorite parts of India.
Yeah, I imagine that must be a lot of fun to see. So are you going back again?
Yeah, probably just before I go to college.
Oh, excellent. All right. Well, no, you'll enjoy that. And Molly Jacobson, you are interested in entomology.
Yeah, it's the study of insects.
Yes, it is. And the University of Iowa has some of your information on their website?
Yeah, on their website, bugguide.net. It's like a whole database of different photos that entomologists and photographers like me have taken, and it's going to help the scientific community find important data about the insects of North America.
And you couple that with your interest in photography.
Yeah, I've been doing it for a long time.
That's
excellent.
That really is. And Roshni, now you speak 5 languages and you've been amazing in spelling bees. Spelling bees? Entomology? Oh my gosh, no. Okay, tell us about that.
Yeah, I speak 3 different Indian languages, English and Spanish. And I won first place in my 8th grade spelling bee and for the school. And I went on to regionals and got 4th place in that.
Oh, that is really wonderful. So at least everything will be spelled correctly no matter what you do. So we will head back into the studio and over to you, Jim, to see how this game turns out.
All right, Lori, thank you. And to the team from Merrimack. Right now we are halfway through the game. Merrimack trailing by just a little bit as we come into our 60-second round. We'll be asking each team 10 questions in 1 minute. We give them 10 points for every correct answer. We bonus them 10 if they get them all right in under a minute. So good luck, teams. Merrimack, you trail, so you can choose the category first from top stories for the birds or the shape of things. Top stories for the birds or the shape of things. Patrick?
Are you sure?
Just do it. Yeah.
I think shape of things would be better.
We need a category.
We'll take the shape of things.
Okay, let's take the shape of things. And again, Patrick, you can talk to everybody, but I do take your answer for the team. We want you to identify the locations with a shape in their name. Start the clock. Mysterious location in the Atlantic Ocean where ships and planes disappear.
Bermuda Triangle.
Correct. Room in the west wing of the White House where the president works.
Oval Office.
Correct. Nelson's Column is in the center of this location in London.
Pass.
Place in Beijing, China, where a lone man faced down a tank in 1989.
Tiananmen Square.
Correct. Where you can watch the ball drop on New Year's Eve.
Times Square.
Correct. Place where Santa Claus and polar bears live.
North Pole.
Arctic Circle. Headquarters of the United States Department of Defense.
The Pentagon.
Correct. Large grassy area between the National Mall and White House where the National Christmas Tree is lit.
What? Pass.
Major intersection in Manhattan named after an explorer.
Pass.
And the Citgo sign is a main feature of this location in Boston, and judges, that is 5 out of 10 on their 60-second round. So let's put 50 points onto the scoreboard for Merrimack and go over to Keene and offer them top stories or for the birds. Top stories or for the birds.
Top stories, please.
All right, let's go with top stories. Leo, I'll be taking your answer for the team. What we want you to do is identify these events ranked by journalists as among the top 100 news stories of the 20th century. Start the clock. This wall came down in 1989.
Berlin Wall.
Correct. Watson and Crick discovered the structure of this in 1953.
DNA.
Correct. This U.S. automotive pioneer implements the assembly line in 1913.
Henry Ford.
Correct. Einstein comes up with this theory.
Theory of relativity.
Correct. The first aviator to fly solo across the Atlantic.
Charles Lindbergh.
Correct. This Mideast country is founded in 1949.
Israel.
Correct. 20 million people worldwide die from this illness in 1918.
Flu.
Influenza.
Correct. This person is named Chancellor of Germany in 1933.
Adolf Hitler.
Correct. This communication device debuts at the New York World's Fair in 1939.
Television.
Correct. This civil rights leader is assassinated April 4th, 1968.
Martin Luther King.
That is it, judges. Perfect. 10 out of 10 on their 60-second round, so let's bonus them 10 as well and put 110 points onto the scoreboard for Keene. Well done. I think that's the third time this season that that's been done. So after three now, Keene holds on to the lead of 220 to 120 with one big round remaining. 10-point toss-ups the rest of the way. No more talking up there, everybody, and here we go. Identify two of the three states in which Cumberland Gap National Historical Park, named for the famous mountain pass explored by Daniel Boone, is located. The states are Kentucky, Tennessee, and Virginia. In physics, which word designates the component of force that acts in line with, but in the opposite direction to, an object's line of motion through the air? We have Miles of Keene. Merrimack. Patrick.
Friction.
It is drag. Paper and pencil in front of you, everybody. Let's try one of these. What is the sum of the ages of Tom and his mother? If his mother is twice as old as Tom and the difference of their ages is 29. What is the sum of the ages of Tom and his mother? If his mother is twice as old as Tom and the difference of their ages is 29. Anjou of Merrimack.
87.
87 is correct. This 17th century Dutch artist is known for his portraits and etchings. Some of his works include The Night Watch, The Anatomy, a Lesson of Dr. Tulp, and The Man in a Gold Hat. 17th century Dutch artist. Miles of Keene.
Rembrandt?
Rembrandt is correct. This official New Hampshire holiday was celebrated on the fourth Monday in April until it was replaced by Civil Rights Day in 1991. Well, before your time, but at that time we used to celebrate Fast Day. 2 minutes to go in the game. Which term is used in botany for active only during the daytime? Miles of Keene.
Diurnal.
Diurnal is right. Name the astronomer whose theory Italian astronomer Galileo confirmed when he became convinced that all planets, including the Earth, revolve around the sun. Shelby of Keene.
Copernicus.
Copernicus is right. This New Hampshire congressman, senator, and Free Soil Party candidate for president is considered to be the first openly abolitionist U.S. senator. Ironically, his daughter Lucy, Patrick of Merrimack.
Franklin Pierce.
I can repeat it for Keene. This New Hampshire congressman, senator, and Free Soil Party candidate for president, considered to be the first openly abolitionist U.S. senator. Ironically, his daughter Lucy was secretly engaged to John Wilkes Booth. That congressman was John Hale. Just under a minute to play. Name the porous volcanic rock that people often use to scrub their skin. Miles of Keene.
Pumice.
Pumice is right. Give the common name for calcium carbonate. Shelby of Keene.
Chalk.
Chalk is correct. Let's skip the next one, judges. By how many degrees Celsius do the boiling point and freezing point of water differ? Anjou of Merrimack.
100.
100 is right. Which part of the human body, frequently described as vermiform, is also considered to be vestigial? Miles of Keene.
A tail? Oh, an appendix.
Merrimack. You had to take a tail first, and then you said appendix. Appendix is correct. Of the three main classes of foods essential to the body, which one includes all sugars and starches? Miles of Keene. Carbohydrates. We'll put another 10 points onto the board as the sound ends our game. And it will be Keene after a slow start coming back to defeat Merrimack by a final of 280 to 140 tonight. Keene will be moving on into our second round of competition a little bit later on this season, becoming the 15th team to do so. Hope it was a good time for the team from Merrimack. Hope it was a good time for you folks at home as well. We have only one opening round game remaining, and we'll then be in second round of competition. That one game will pit these teams, Bishop Brady High School, against Massenic Regional High School. That comes up 1 week from tonight. We thank you all for watching. Good night. See you next week.